हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू क्षेत्र विद्या मंदिर हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज। दिस इज़ SSC ऑनलाइन ऑडियो वीडियो लेसन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 3 फिजियोग्राफी एंड ड्रेनेज फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 10th बाय मिस दीपा पोदार। सो विद दिस चैप्टर वी स्टडीड मेनी टॉपिक्स एंड ओनली वन लास्ट टॉपिक इज रिमेनिंग, दैट इज़ ड्रेनेज ऑफ इंडिया। Okay, so today we are going to study about our country's drainage, where we are going to study about the oceans, the rivers we have, and from where are we getting the water to the rivers. Okay, so the very first thing we'll study about is Himalayas, Himalaya drainage. Most of the major rivers in Himalaya originated from the various glaciers. Okay, so we all know that in summer season, the glaciers on the mountain starts melting and they discharge water in summer season. So the drainage covers two major rivers such as Sindhu river system and Ganga river system. So from Himalaya we have two rivers, Sindhu and Ganga. So this is how a glacier melts and they start giving waters to the rivers, and the river goes and discharges the water to the ocean. But they form a very, very long journey. Okay, so here it is, the Sindhu River. It is also known as Indus River. Okay, so can you see from Himalaya it is flowing and some part of it also going to Pakistan, right? The majority tributary of river Sindhu, Sultaj, originates near Mansarovar. So if I zoom this for you, and this part has a Mansarovar and flows western to Punjab plains. So it is going towards the Punjab side, and this side is going towards the Pakistan side and meeting the Arabian Sea. Okay. The river Ganga. So I talked about Sindhu River, now we'll go to Ganga River. Okay, see, can you see the Ganga is the largest river in our country. Ganga originates from the Gangotri glaciers. So there is a glacier in Himalaya that is called Gangotri, and when that glacier melts, the river, they form a river, and that is called Ganga River. Another major tributary of Ganga flows through the northern part. Northern part means Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow, Kathmandu, then Bihar, then Bangladesh, West Bengal, and it discharges their water to Bay of Bengal. Okay, now can you see the Ganga is passing through many of places, right? So overall we say it Ganga, but when it passes through Himalaya, it is also called as Sangpo. And when they crosses Himalaya and goes towards the other side, it is also called as Dihang. And when the water flows toward the eastern side, okay, the lower side, or maybe we can say Bihar side or Bangladesh side, it is also called as Brahmaputra when they reaches to Bangladesh, right? So this is how it is changing their name also when they are crossing the different places. Okay, Ganga receive a number of tributes from peninsula like Chambal, Ken, Betawa, Shaun, Damodar, etc. So this was all about Ganga and Indus River, or we can say Sindhu River. So I hope you understood this. Let me go to a next topic, that is Peninsular River. So I told you last time also, what is the peninsular area of our country? The places which has coastal area can also be called as peninsular area. So in the peninsular area, we are going to study about the river that they have. Okay, now peninsular river system can further be divided into two things. So this part is divided into two things. For half part of the river are meeting Arabian Sea, and half part of the rivers are meeting Bay of Bengal. So in the Western Ghat, from a major water divide in peninsula, the peninsula rivers begin rain-fed river. So when we could talk about peninsula river, they are not a river which are like always been there. They are the river that is rain-fed river, seasonal river. You will not see river there all the time. Okay, they are seasonal in nature. In the rainy season, you'll see. In the summer season, for some time you'll see, but after some time, the water evaporates. Okay. The flowing river occupies the area between Western Ghat and Arabian Coastal, are short in length but swift. So here what they are saying, the peninsula rivers are very short in length, okay, but they are very swift. Swift means the water passes by very easily. And there are some rivers exist in Kerala, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Gujarat also. Okay. Now, there is a river called Narmada. Narmada will also be called as Peninsular River. Okay, see, I'll try to explain you. Narmada flows slowly through Rift Valley. Last time I showed you the picture of Rift Valley. So that is how Narmada passes through. Mahi River flows from northeast to south direction, where River Sabarmati collecting its headwater from south slopes for Aravali's range from the somewhat north-south direction. So here what they are saying, Narmada is passing through Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh and everything, right? When they are passing to Gujarat, it is also called as Sabarmati, and they are discharging their water to Arabian Sea. It originates along the western slopes of Aravali range and discharges water to southeast direction and flow into the Gulf of Kutch. Okay. So this was all about Narmada. Let me go to rivers meeting Bay of Bengal. Now, this is the last part of our chapter. That is, we are going to talk about few rivers which are meeting Bay of Bengal. Okay. Now, most of the area of peninsula is drained by river flowing towards Bay of Bengal. Now, most of the rivers are discharging their water to Bay of Bengal, okay, and very less rivers are there which are discharging their water to Arabian Sea, okay. So here we are going to talk about the important river system in the group are Mahanandi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. Kaveri originates in eastern slope of Western Ghats. So here I will try to show you Godavari. Okay, see, can you see it? You can also see Tapi and Narmada here, Mahi River. So right now, just focus on Godavari River. Godavari River is the second largest river system in India. And the first largest is, yes, Ganga River. And they are discharging their water into Bay of Bengal. Okay. So here we are. To the south of the Godavari is located the river Krishna. Okay, there is a river called Krishna. Its major tributaries are Bhima and Tungabhadra. Now, I will show you river Kaveri. River Kaveri basin flows through the state of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. It is on the major river of peninsula. Now, even Kaveri River is a major river of peninsula, as they are used for irrigation since long time. We all know that in South India there are things, or there are a few things where the people do agriculture of, right? So River Krishna and Kaveri gives them water for the agriculture and helps them to do some irrigation, and it is happening from long time, right? So this was all about this chapter, and here I'm showing you the main river lakes of our country. So in this map you can find everything, okay? River Indus, Jhelum, Ravi, Saltuj, Yamuna, Ganga, then Narmada, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, everything is there. So just open your textbook and spend some time with it. Okay? Now here, this is what I wanted to discuss with you in my last video also. So this is a square kilometer or just then statistical information about Ganga River and Amazon River. So Amazon River is world's largest river and Ganga River is India's largest river. So just check the difference they have. The square feet of Ganga is 10,16,124 kilometer and Amazon has 70,50,000 kilometer. So can you see how huge it is? The total length of river, now total length of river we are talking about now, is 2,525 kilometer and Amazon is 6,400 kilometer. So can you see, it is a big amount, it is like very very big and large river. And the water discharge, they discharge 6,640 cum per second and Amazon discharges 2,09,000 liter water per second. So I hope you understood the difference, like how large and how big Amazon River is and how important it is for the planet Earth, right? So with this, I am completing the chapter. Thank you so much for your attention. I hope you are reading the textbook also. So do solve the questions given in the end of the textbook and write them out on your workbook. Stay home, stay safe, and have a good day. Thank you.